In this example, we're going to graph the rational function y equal x over x squared minus 4. To do this, we're first going to find all of the horizontal and vertical asymptotes. We find the vertical asymptotes by looking at what values of x makes the denominator 0. In this case, x squared minus 4 is 0 when x equals 2, and also when x equals negative 2. We can factor x squared minus 4 into x plus 2 times x minus 2, and we can see clearly that 2 and negative 2 are our values. So the vertical asymptotes will be the vertical lines x equal 2 and the vertical line x equal negative 2. We plot these two vertical lines. The graph will take off vertically up and or down for x values close to 2 and negative 2. This is our vertical boundary. Our next asymptote is our horizontal asymptote, and we can find that asymptote by using the rules for asymptotes that involve the degrees. The degree of the numerator is 1 because our numerator is x to the first. The degree of the denominator is 2 because our denominator is x squared minus 4. Since the degree of the numerator is less than the degree of the denominator, the horizontal asymptote will be y equals 0. And this is because the denominator is growing bigger quicker than the numerator for large x values, so the y value is getting closer and closer to 0. So our horizontal boundary is the horizontal line y equals 0, which is the line that goes right over the x-axis. Now we're ready to find some points to finish our graph. We start out with some points in the middle. When x equals 0, y equals 0. It gives us this point. We want to find points on each side of each vertical asymptote. So we'd probably plug in 1 for x. And that gives us 1 over 1 squared minus 4, or 1 over negative 3, which is negative 1/3. So here's the point 1, negative 1/3. Then we plug in negative 1, and we get negative 1 over positive 1 minus 4, or negative 1 over negative 3 for the y value, which simplifies to positive 1/3. So when x is negative 1, we get y equal positive 1/3. And if you notice something, when I put in opposite values of x, I got opposite values of y. And that's because this happens to be an odd function. We plug in x equal 3, and we get 3 over 3 squared minus 4, or 3 over 9 minus 4. And that simplifies to 3 fifths. So when x is 3, y is 3 fifths. And when x is negative 3, we get y equal negative 3 fifths. And then just maybe one more point on each side. If we plug in x equals 6, we get 6 over 36 minus 4, or 6 over 32, which simplifies to 3 sixteenths. And when x is negative 6, we get y equal negative 3 sixteenths. So now when we plug those points in, we get a bunch of points that almost looks like a snake there, snaking along. And if we were just to draw a line from left to right, that's what we get. But we have to use our knowledge of the asymptotes. We know that as x gets close to those vertical asymptotes, the graph takes off straight up or straight down. We also know that the graph levels off to the horizontal asymptote out on the ends. So what we have is the graph leveling off to x equal or y equals 0 out on the far left, and then it trends down, which means it's going to go straight down as it gets close to x equal negative 2. On the right side of x equal negative 2, we can see that the graph is kind of trending up. So as it gets close to x equal negative 2 from the right, the graph goes straight up. And then it crosses through the origin, and then it trends down as it heads towards x equal 2. And it heads down toward negative infinity. And on the right side of x equal 2, we see the graph levels off to the x-axis on the far right, and it takes off kind of straight up on the right side. And my graph's a little bit squiggly here, but that's pretty much what it looks like. And here I've superimposed the actual graph, and you can see that's what we have. An S-curve in the middle and two graphs that trail off to the x-axis on the right from above and from below on the left. And they also, the graphs take off to positive or negative infinity near the vertical asymptotes.